And today our man in jazz is Wes Montgomery. And many years ago, about 1959, well, it was indeed in 1959, a dear old friend with whom I had been associated...
All right, guys, how's it going? Remember how in one of the last videos I was kind of talking about how I didn't have a tripod because my last one broke? Well, I actually ordered a new tripod. Amazon lost it. So they sent me another tripod. And then the old one came, so now I have two tripods. And what does that mean, you ask? What does two tripods mean? Mega tripod. You heard it here first. Mega tripod. I can only imagine it now. Just think about it. I know you guys think about it. So I was just scouring the internet for a bit. I actually kind of decided to get an Amazon Basics one just because they seem like a really good deal for the price. I don't know, I think they're around 20 bucks. So you really can't go wrong, and they have lots of reviews. They're very flexible. I don't know, what's the word, customizable. You can do a lot of things with them. So yeah, and now I have two. Mega tripod. How's it going, guys? Today we are back with another car information video, and today we're going to be breaking down things you can do to enhance your Subaru WRX / STI's reliability. And we're going to kind of break this video off into two different segments, one being behavioral patterns, behavioral things you can do to help improve your reliability, and one being more of an aftermarket support or in tuning things to enhance your reliability on your WRX / STI. All right, and starting with the behavior pattern, we're going to be talking about WOT. So what does WOT mean? If you're unfamiliar with the term, it actually means wide open throttle. And what that basically means is when you go pedal to the metal and your throttle body completely opens up. And why we're talking about that is because it has a lot to do with engine load. Have you ever been in the wrong gear? Just say you upshift too early, or you didn't mean to, and you go to press on your gas and you feel your engine shaking. That is engine load, and that can be very, very detrimental to your Subaru engine's lifespan. Engine load can lead to many internal issues, basically caused with, especially with EJ engines, with oil circulation issues that can cause rod knock, ringland failure, and many horrible things that basically blows up your engine. And so over time, if you're constantly going into wide open throttle and at the wrong RPM, this engine load will slowly but surely deteriorate the internals of your engine, and it can cause very, very detrimental effects. And so basically my recommendation on fixing this behavior is to always make sure you're above 3000 RPM if you're gonna floor your WRX. I know it kind of sucks, but it's just kind of something you have to do, or else you're going to have to face with the consequences. So always make sure that you're around 3000 RPM minimum. Some people might say higher, some people might say lower. My recommendation is around 3000 RPM. That's very doable. And so obviously just make sure you're downshifting, make sure you're in the correct RPM range, and you should have no issues, because that's one of the biggest reasons why many people get rod knock, you know, and ringland failures, is because they're putting too much stress on their engine because of wide open throttle. And it leads to so many internal issues. And it's that simple. Just make sure, and when you're going hard into boost, that you're just in the appropriate RPM range. And with that being said, if you put engine load in your car once or once in a while, it's not going to be a big deal. Obviously, mistakes happen, and if you do it every once in a while, it won't blow up your engine. But if you have a behavior constantly going into boost or flooring it from 1000 RPM, it's gonna be an issue eventually. So just try to avoid that. My next part of behavior is routine maintenance. So this kind of seems like a cliche. If you take care of your car takes care of you. Not necessarily. WRXs, in my opinion, are kind of, you can't really tell. Sometimes you can do regular maintenance all the time and it blows up. Sometimes you have someone who does no regular maintenance and they have a perfectly reliable Subaru. Why that is, I don't know. I wish I knew. But obviously you should be doing your regular maintenance on time and just be making sure you're using really high quality oils, quality parts such as timing belts, spark plugs, all that stuff. And my recommendation to help improve reliability with routine maintenance is to do it before the actual date, the actual suggested timeline. So for example, when you're doing a timing belt, because timing belt is really, 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 I want to stress this, really important on the WRX because they are interference engines. So basically what that means is if your timing belt were to break or to seize, because it's an interference engine, your engine is going to be totally done, donezo, if your timing belt fails. If you're unfamiliar with my story, I actually purchased a WRX and it had a premature, the tension idler seized prematurely on my timing belt. I think it was about 5,000, 10,000 kilometers early. And what that led to is my whole entire internals going out of time and bad stuff happened. So my recommendation is, so Subaru says to do it about every 1,000 miles. So approximately every 100,000 miles. I think their actual number is 105,000 miles to do your timing belt. I would suggest doing it around 80 to 90,000. Obviously, you don't have to. That's just my suggestion. You don't want to risk that stuff. You're going to have to do it eventually. So what is 10,000 miles in the long run, on the long term? It's not that much. So just do your regular maintenance, and it's always better to do it before you have issues rather than wait and have issues afterwards. And whether that be doing your oil changes a bit early, your time belt a bit early, your spark plugs a bit early. Obviously, the spark plugs aren't as big of a deal, but do your oil change, just do your all your fluids before you have the issues. All right, and so the next segment is modifications and tuning. So I'll start off with modifications. My recommendation, and obviously you guys can have your own opinion, and that is completely fine, but it is to buy the best quality mods, the best quality parts that you can find for whatever modification you want. So obviously, you can buy eBay, you know, exhaust, and you'll be fine. You know, you can go on eBay. eBay has, just because it's from eBay doesn't mean it's horrible, basically. But my recommendation is it's better to be patient and to save your money and to buy, you know, those cob parts than to go rush and get a full cart of eBay parts and load up your car with those bad welds and stuff. And eventually, the reliability is just going to go downhill if you're buying, you know, subpar quality parts. It's really important to buy these quality parts because they're made with more consistency. You're going to run into less, you know, cracks on the welds, that type of thing. Things that can throw off your air fuel ratios, that type of thing. So one of my recommendations is to buy quality parts. My next suggestion for keeping your WRX reliable, that doesn't really need to be on, but whatever, it's to always make sure if you're modifying your WRX/STI that you always have a tune. Whether you're just throwing a simple intake on your car, you know, exhaust, I don't know about exhaust. If you're just putting on a simple catback, you know, you might not need a tune. But if you're doing intake, even an intake, in my opinion, requires a tune. And whether that be a cob access port, you know, the off-the-shelf tunes, or whether you go get a pro tune from a local shop. It's really, really important to have tunes on your engine because basically when you're adding, you know, that even that simple air intake, you're changing, you know, the air fuel ratios, you're changing the way your engine wants to think, and your engine does not know how to compensate for the different air intake coming in. You know, the stock engine does not necessarily know how to deal with different parts other than OEM. It is very important if you're going to go aftermarket, make sure you always have the correct tunes. It sounds simple, but lots of people don't do it. So make sure you do. It can lead to many issues. I know someone who just put a cold air intake on their WRX, on their stock WRX, and it threw off their air fuel ratios, and it actually caused a bunch of internal damage, which caused them about $2,000 in repairs. I think it was actually covered by warranty, but you know what I mean? He got lucky with that. You know what I mean? Just a simple mod can actually really be detrimental to a WRX. You know, they're an engine that can be beaten on, but they're also an engine that can be very, very sensitive to certain things such as mods. And the last segment is actual parts you can put on your WRX or STI that will help improve reliability. So I've heard lots of people actually say, you know, there isn't actually very solid proof for some of these parts that they actually are directly correlated to higher reliability, but I mean, it doesn't hurt to do these things because, you know, it can help. So to start off, we have upgraded oil pump, high pressure oil pump. So that obviously helps with the flow of your engine. You know, the raw knock and all that stuff has to do with inefficient oil flow in your Subaru WRX EJ engine. So that's very important, oil pumps. It just makes sense. When I actually bought my JDM engine in my WRX, I was actually told that the JDM engines have a better oil pump than the US ones. Who knows if that's actually true, but because of that, people do believe that the JDM engines have better reliability because of the increased oil flow. With that being said, we also have the oil catch can. A lot of people say, you know, do your oil catch can, that can lead to higher reliability. It's kind of the same thing with the oil pump. You know, it makes sense in theory. Is it actually true? I don't know. I would like to think it's true because inefficient oil flow can be really bad for EJ205. Obviously, for any car, inefficient oil flow is bad. But it makes sense. So I would definitely feel comfortable upgrading things that can help oil flow and that whole process. So it definitely can't hurt. The last part, which is kind of a given, is to upgrade to forged internals. Obviously, this is very expensive, but if you want a very reliable Subaru, forged internals is the way to go. I can't imagine how much it would actually cost. I would say around $5,000 plus. I'll have to do more research on that. That's a complete estimate. But forged internals, really strong internals, forged with fire, will definitely help your reliability, obviously. That makes sense. With that being said, I hope this video can help you guys become more reliable with your WRX and not have issues like this guy. I think a lot of the issues and reliability issues that WRXs actually have come from behavioral patterns, behavioral things such as wide open throttle, you know, boosting too early, not really boosting, but you know, wide open throttle issues, engine load issues. It can lead to a lot of bad things. I don't know if you guys noticed, but I actually got monetized on YouTube. So maybe you actually guys saw an ad on this, just a little off life update, which is awesome. I obviously don't really care about the money. You know, I just enjoy making YouTube videos, but it is awesome to be monetized because now I can put more money into my channel, you know, buying more parts and that type of thing. I actually just bought a GoPro on Black Friday. I got it for a really good deal. So expect more better driving videos because I can have dual cam set up, you know, one with the point of view and one on me. And also a little life update is I'm actually getting a puppy, so expect to see some puppy vlogs. I know this isn't a vlogging channel necessarily, it's more of a car channel, but I thought I would throw some puppy vlogs on here. But I guess we'll see. With that being said, I really appreciate you guys, all your guys' support. It has been unreal lately. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Yeah.